Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, it's Sofox here, and you're watching me attempt to cast StarCraft 2. Now, today I have something different than what I usually do, where I collect replays from Cassid or just get a replay sent to my personal mail. This is actually a game from the recent DreamHack Winter, and it is round 1, I believe, and we're playing on Metropolis, if I'm correct. I hope I'm really correct, because I think I read the name of the map pack. You can find the map pack somewhere on Reddit. I think I will leave the link to the map pack in the description down below. Now let's start introducing our players. This is best of 3, and now playing on the left side of the map, playing in the red shirt. So yes, I said shirt. I'm gonna drop the whole trouser thing. It is his in-name game is Quantic State, but it is actually Quantic the SDC. And playing above him, playing in the very, very beautiful pink color, playing Zerg, it is the one and the only evil geniuses, Stefano, my personally most favorite player. Let's start this match. Now, they're playing on, I think, Metropolis. I really hope it's Metropolis. I actually never played on this map, simply because I really didn't play so much, but well, doesn't matter. Now, I don't know if I'm gonna cast all 3 games that they play, because like I said, it's the best of 3. Oh, did I just spoil something? I didn't say anything. I don't know if I will cast all of the games. I may cast all of the games. I may cast just this one. We will see. This is a little longer game, and I don't understand why the creep tumors are out here, but I really like this position of expansion. I can see myself harassing them with Banshees as a Terran player, but doesn't matter. Now we have a TVZ here, so I don't know what to see. I don't know what to expect, actually. So our SDC is making his first supply depot here to block off that ramp. He's not going for any sort of early base, so he's probably gonna go for a supply depot, then barracks down here right next to it as soon as he gets 150 minerals. Or I may be wrong, because he hasn't queued up an SCV to go down and build it. Well, in the meanwhile, Stefano is going for his normal Stefano thing, which is gonna be, I think, to go for an early expansion and then add a spawning pool right around here, right around, I think, 16, 17 drones, or maybe he's just gonna go scout. No, he's gonna go place down a spawning pool. In the meantime, the SDC is actually not doing anything. He's saving up minerals, so he's gonna go for expand first, expanding it to the natural base, which is very easily defendable on this map because, oh wait, I take that back, it's not so easily defendable, because there's actually 3 ways to get to this. See, you're gonna get through here, and through here if you destroy this rocks here. And he's building a command center right up his ramp here to prevent any sort of scout to try and prevent it, and beside it, it's gonna go, the barracks gonna go down, so we will see a nice little play here preventing any scouting, but there's an overlord already here. In the meantime, Stefano is going for the hatchery first, so no early aggression from him, as well as building a spawning pool. So he's just building a spawning pool so early. I mean, it's not so early because he went for hatchery first. He's building a spawning pool to build a few links and, of course, queens to prevent any sort of early push. But as we can see, and as he can probably see too with that overlord here, let's see. Yes, he saw the the command center going down, so he knows there's no high early aggression in the form of maybe Banshees or something similar. But another barrack is going down for the SDC at this moment. Excuse me, I didn't put down this thingy here. So yeah, the SDC is probably gonna go and scout to see what opponents has. He can create offensive units in the shape of Marines now, while our other player here, Stefano, hasn't been making anything, so he hasn't spawned any Zerglings. He's making 2 queens to saturate this base to get those Larva Injects, because everybody loves Larva Injects. And one thing I really love about Stefano is he doesn't miss a single Larva Inject. I may be able to focus on that just a little bit later in the game, but I sincerely doubt that I will be able to focus on that. Like I said, he doesn't miss any sort of any Larva Inject whatsoever with his queens. He has probably a great technique of doing that. Now, we see one Marine going down here to scout where his opponent at, because this is not a cross-position map only, as you can see. I think it's not cross-position map only, so the SDC doesn't know where opponent is. Actually, Stefano got lucky with that overlord, with positioning of that overlord, so he knows his opponent right away. And now we see at the SDC, I always keep messing that up, the SDC is going for his expansion, moving the command center down there, which he turned into orbital command as well as his main base. And now we see double gas going from Stefano on the natural base here, which is the thing that Zergs are doing lately, going for the natural so they can have late game gas if they expand this, expand Doesn't matter if they waste these two gases, they can always build the gases on the natural, on the main here, excuse me. And we see a little push coming from Quantic State here, but I think that Stefano will be able to deal with it. There's two queens here and that debris here to block the path. Maybe a few links will not go amiss, but I think that Stefano actually noticed that there's an SCV, so we may see a bunker going down here, somewhere around here, and there's a third up for Stefano, as well as a third command center for STC building down here. He will try to remove this rubble before he goes and expands the third bay, because it's very, very hard to go around here, and it takes units a long time to get to here, and his opponent is actually closer to him than he is to his third base than he is. And now we see a little attack to this third hatchery here from Stefano here, and a bunker being built down to the third, so he may be able to deny Stefano this third base. That will be crucial, because as we all know, Zerg need a lot of, and I mean a lot of profit, a lot of minerals here, and he's moving those slow moving two queens down there. The bunker is finished, so we'll be able to load those units into the bunker. There's more marines out of the way. I don't know how Stefano will be able to handle this. That's a lot of links, but if I don't think those links will be able to take it out. They will. No, they will be able to take it out, but there's another bunker on the way here. Four units go out. Those marines will get slaughtered here if Stefano micros did correctly. Those two queens moving in, and the marines finally gets cleaned up, but there's more marines. Only two marines actually here on the way for STC. Two more on the Zelnaga tower here. So finally, the Stefano, yes, I'm gonna call him, the Stefano managed to reflect that attack, but that was a lot of wasted mining time for Stefano here, and I really think the Quantic is in the advantage now. The Quantic, what was he doing in the meantime? He took it up, he made a factory here, and he's taken double gas on his natural as well as on his main, double engineering bay going down, and a starport, so he'll be making that bio force here reinforced with medevacs. And in the meantime, Stefano has been building double evolution chamber as well as a roach war, so some roach play will be going down here. See him researching ground level Zerg ground carapace plus one, as well as Zerg mainly plus one, so he will still be sticking two links here. Link speed is almost done, as well as Stimpact and plus one for the SDC, as well as a few Vikings here to probably do what? To poke on those little, how do you call them, overlords there. And now one Banshee gets denied by those roaches here, as he knows he's not getting in there while those roaches are up there, because roaches are very effective against Banshees. And now again, Stefano is taking those gases on his third base. Did he take them in his natural base? Yes. Main base? Yes, he did. So Stefano is working on four gases right now, gonna be transferring droves in those gases right away, and another two barracks going down for the SC, so he's arming up for a great attack. Did the third command center go down yet? No, it didn't. It's still here, so he's probably going for that one timing attack, not making a lot of units, but there's a few units on the field, not enough to make any sort of push, but now he's gonna go and clear that debris here for the SCVs to be able to get here. And now one alien is going up to the north to poke at Stefano to see if he's taking a fort. And now Stefano, I think Stefano is just a little bit behind, because he's not making a lot of units. There's a few roaches on the field, there's not a lot of units overall. There's 5 roaches on the field and 12 lings, excuse me. That's not gonna be enough to defend against this force little here. It may well be, but Stim and Combat Shield should be done very, very soon. I think it's done already. Let us see. Stim is gonna be done. Combat Shield is done, if I'm correct. No, excuse me, it's not done, but 1-1 is done. So at this point of time, I think that STC has a little bit of advantage over his opponent here, but not anything crucial. So he's building an armory, so he's gonna go for that quick 2-2, and there it is, the quick 2-2 for STC, as well as Combat Shield. In the meanwhile, our Zerg player, aka Stefano, is taking his 4th base, so he's going for a very, very greedy play. Taking his 4th base, sacrificing unit count for economy, because at the moment, STC is not putting any pressure on him in the form of Banshee harassment or anything similar. So Stefano is given the opportunity to really, really reinforce his army, and an infestation pit has gone down, as well as pathogen gland is being researched, and 2-2 for the Zerglings down here. So we will see what goes on. I think that Stefano is in the advantage at the moment, because he's being let, STC has let him to do whatever he wants. There's a drop coming down to this right side, but we'll see where it decides to go. He's probably gonna go and circle around, try to get it to the fourth base that is not well defended. There's not a lot of units around here. There's absolutely no units around here, but the creep spread off Stefano is really, really great. It's really, really great. Oh, we see Terran vehicle level plus one going for our Terran player here, which is very, very strange because I think he has only one factory operational here, so he might be going for a few tanks to reinforce that little force he has here. Yeah, two tanks here that don't have siege mode at the moment, but that is being researched as well. At that drop, it's getting very, very close to this third base. There's nothing to defend it except a few links, but there's actually nothing to destroy at this third base. There's a lot of units near it. If he decides to drop here, that might be a very bad idea, but he puts them on the high ground so he can take down units without any problem, because Stefano doesn't see it. And now a big force of Link is coming up there. They're in the corner. They're gonna get surrounded if the ST doesn't hurry up. Oh, he picks him up, only losing two units. Great play from the STC here. I gotta say, really great play, managing to take out a few units here. And now two workers. I mean, it's not only two workers, but well. And now Stefano is going for a big counterattack here. There's some units in the middle, but I don't think that SCV will be able to stop from counterattacking. He will need to go in a defensive state. But Stefano actually drops this counterattack for now, it seems. And STC is just begging to get that 2-2 over so he can deal with this counterattack. Not a lot of barracks on the field. Three more being produced here. Two more being produced here at the moment. So he's looking to expand. He has expanded to his fourth base here. Third. Is that third? Fourth base, excuse me. He has fourth bases. So they're kind of even in economy. But Stefano had his fourth base really, really early. And now another drop to this fourth base gets picked up right away, trying to kill a few units from spawning here. That's a few Zerglings being spawned and a Spire going down for our Zerg player Stefano. Now, is he gonna attempt to drop to this fourth base? Third base, excuse me. Yes, he will attempt to drop to this third base. There's a lot of units here, so that will be denied very effectively by Stefano here. If he does not decide to move out, he decides to move out. There's not a lot of units here to defend against this. There's a few Banelings morphing here, and now the drop comes in. A few Roaches here and Lings to defend it. I think they will be cleaned up very, very easily. And now Stefano moves in the middle with a lot of units here. 2-0 for the Roaches and 2-2 for the Zerlings, if I'm correct. Yes, I'm correct. There's not a lot of units here, but they have Steam Combat Shield and I think 2-2 at this point of time, those Marines. So I think that STC should be okay here. Those tanks have... Oh, what's the heck? Heck is going on with my frame rate here? I don't know. Frame rate is really low. Excuse me. Let me stop the game for a second. Stop. Yes, stop. Excuse me. Let me stop this game for a second. My frame rate is really dropping low. Let's do this. Oh, my frame rate is still really low. And there's gonna be a big clash in the middle if Stefano does not pull back. And this force will be evaporated very, very quickly because those Marines are very much upgraded. Now, a scan goes down to clean up a few of those creep tumors. There will be no contest whatsoever from Stefano. Stefano is amassing his units in the middle here while STC is going out. Now, STC, in the meantime, is producing two more starports and two more command centers to expand even more. Now, we see a big clash in the middle here. Those Marines will get cleaned up because of the nice split from Stefano here, and he's reinforcing his forces. And reinforcing his forces, that doesn't make any sense. Removing his forces. Two tanks are sieged up. Not a lot of them are sieged up. Oh, and now they're sieged up. I don't think that force will be able to do here. Nice little fungal of those Marines here. I don't know if that was necessary. And those Zerglings got in the range of those tanks, got wiped out. And I think that the STC is just gonna wait here for a second. But no, he decides to do a drop here and there, and pulls back with those tanks. He doesn't want to lose them. Tanks are very, very useful. Now, in the meantime, those two command centers should be done up and operational. And another spawning pool going down for... another spawning pool going down for our Zerg player here. What happened to his previous spawning pool? Might have it gotten destroyed? I really don't know. Tree is also on the way for him as flyer attacks number one, so we might see some Utilis on the way. We see Broodlords. Ah, have never ever seen, I mean, casted a game with Broodlords in it. Broodlords are so goddamn overpowering. A drop on the turret base. There's a lot of units here that will get cleaned up. Picks up a few units STC and gets the hell out of there. They're not worth the risk and the sacrifice. Now, in the meantime, he distracts Stefano. Now, he's going in the middle, moving up to this, cleaning up these creep tumors here as much as he can. Moving his forces to the natural base here if he can. Some Zerglings on the way, but I think it will be dropped. As you can see, STC and Stefano are equal. And I really do mean equal in supply. 3-3 is done, I think, here for the STC. No, only three weapons is done for the STC, and 3-3 should be done in a few seconds for Zerg for those Broodlings, I think. Yes, Broodlings should have 3-3. Are they melee? Broodlings, are they melee? Yes, I think they are. We will see what happens. And now, High Tech out to tracking is going down for our Terran player. So he noticed those Broodlings. Yes, Broodlings, excuse me. Broodlings? Broodlords? Broodlords! So he's putting down a few turrets here and there. Probably gonna put them down. I may be wrong. There's a Raven going down in case of some kind of stealth play here from his Zerg opponent, and we see Corvid reactor as well as seeker missile being researched for the Ravens. Ravens are a great response to Broodlord, but there's not a lot of them on the field actually. And there's a little clash in the middle. Those Marines going up. There's a and nice fungus on those Marines from Stefano. Gets them cleaned up with a few roaches. SC has to pull back, loading those Marines into those medevacs here. And now he's gonna drop on the high ground here. As Stefano might not be able to see it. No, Stefano reaches up here. Oh, if those Broodlords get here, that's gonna be a real mess. Those corrupts try to take down those medevacs here, but nice one drop of Marine to distract his opponent. That was really nice from him. Now we see a Viking. I thought he was gonna make another base here. Now we see four bases being mined from here. Five bases building, working on a fifth base here. The SDC and now putting these two downs to defend himself. Probably gonna morph this one into a planetary fortress as well. This is a really nice match. I'm really, really loving it. We're gonna see some seeker missiles going here, and I think this match is pretty even here. There's a nice little force of Marines here with 3-3, just waiting to get loaded up and to go back home, or maybe potentially just drop here. There's not a lot of units here to defend against this. This hatchery might just get taken out in time before Stefano has time to react. He loads them up in out of range, so he's probably gonna stim them up. Yes, he stims them up and goes directly from the hatchery for the hatchery here. No, he doesn't go directly, he goes for the workers. There's there's a lot of units here, so this is gonna get cleaned up without a problem, actually. That's really a lot of units. A few units get rescued, but a nice fungal of those medevacs, and they're gonna get taken out. Unfortunately, there's a few units in those medevacs, they're gonna get taken out. Both players are going for big, long micro games. SDC, I think he has a little bit of an advantage here. That's a nice little number of Vikings he have here. Let's see what the unit count is at the moment. SDC is in the lead with drones, but he's not so much in the lead with the armies, I think. He's got only 31 Marine and only 1 Marauder, 7 tanks, 9 Vikings, and 4 medevacs, which is really, really low, but, well, they are covered by those Ravens here that do have seeker missile and auto turrets, so that's gonna be great for them. They don't have energy, although now 2 tanks and a few Marines are getting dropped into this base, I think, because it's the least defended base. But with those speed, Zerlings can get there in no time, and I really do think that Stefano is in the lead now. Though I keep changing my mind, but I think Stefano is in the lead because there's not a lot of units for Quantic State here. There's those Zerglings, they're gonna get cleaned up very easily if those tanks don't get teased up. Those tanks don't get teased up in time, that tank is gonna get destroyed. Unfortunately, really unfortunately for the SDC, they get cleaned up. That's a nice little force he has here. A lot of Marines and, I mean, a lot of Infestors here. So that's gonna be brutal against those bio units of our Terran player here of the SDC. Now, I see a lot of base here. We see Stefano getting a lot of base. He got 2 more bases on this right side. He's preventing his opponent from actually taking those bases with that big force. And now Stefano is moving out with those Broodlords. Oh, they have 1-1 as well as those Broodlings that have 3-3. We will see what happens. And now Quantic States notices those Broodlords advance here. So he will not try to attack you, or he will. Yes, that's a lot of Marines here. He might be able to take him out because they're opposition. But now the rest of the forces finally come here. There's a few Banelings in that mix. If they crush into those tanks, when they are sieged out, they will be able to do a lot of damage. Whew, that was a lot of words in a short span of time. But for now, Stefano falls back to his natural base. And what did I say natural base? His natural state, which is a defensive state at the moment, because there's not a lot of Broodlords at the moment to defend. But Stefano's supply is capped, so he might as well go soon now, waiting for those upgrades to finish, actually, before he attacks. While Quantic State has not been able to maximize his unit scout to get to 200 supply, because he keeps dropping at Stefano. He keeps losing a lot of units with those drops. But he has a nice... he has a nice number of units here to be able to defend against this. But we see a fusion core going down, so we might see some battle cruisers in the mix here. It would be a nice thing to see some battle cruisers. There's the units maybe clash in the middle. Oh, if those Vikings were caught out of position, they might the game might be GG right away. Because Quantic State has mined out most of his bases, doesn't have a lot of minerals here or a lot of income whatsoever. These two bases are only one that I'm mining from at the moment, and this one just a little bit, but natural expansion, third and second, second and third, excuse me, oh my god, I'm so confused, are mined out to the fullest. Now, I think Stefano will move out very soon here, because 2-2 is almost finished, as well as 2-4 the Roaches, and now my frame rate has finally been normalized, but we will see. There's two planetary fortress here, I mean planetary forces and a orbital command, so we will see if Stefano decides to engage with that. It will be a lot of loss for him in the form of those ground units, which are mostly consisted of banelings and infestors with a few zerglings here and there. So we will see what decides to happen. Scans going down to see the exact magnitude of this army. That's a lot of units, that's really a lot of Broodlords. I don't know what the STC can really do now. He doesn't have the income to actually produce so many units if he loses this army. And Stefano has got great income, he's got so many working bases here that he doesn't have to worry about money. He has 4,000 minerals banked up, so he will be able to replenish this army if he loses it. And now I think they're gonna engage here in the middle. Infestor Terran going down, as well as a few Fungals on the Ravens. There's a lot of Fungals, a big stim for Quantic State here. Those Corruptors engaged, those Broodlings are being held back at the moment, but look at this, all of the Marines from Quantic, from the SC have been evaporated, just those few tanks standing up here. I think this is gonna be GG for Stefano, for Quantic State. Stefano is gonna win here, definitely. The fleet is trying to retreat, to try to stay out of cover, but there's a few Corruptors here that might be able to do a lot of damage. I think this is GG, definitely GG for the Quantic State here. He won't be able to defend against this, because as we see, Stefano is making more Corruptors, so that means more Corruptors, but more Corruptors. Now Stefano can freely advance into his opponent's base, but he doesn't have any ground units whatsoever, so he needs to take down these two bases very easily. Now those Vikings make a return, trying to do a lot of damage here, but not gonna happen. I think there's a few ghosts in the mix. Infestor Terran going down to this third base, fourth, fifth, sixth, I don't know what base it is, going down to this base. And this is a big clash in the middle, trying to take down that planetary fortress from doing a lot of damage to those infestors here. This is a big clash. Those Marines will get pushed back, but they try to do a lot of damage here, but that's a lot of Broodlings. I don't think he will be able to do anything. More Corruptors on the way to deal with that Air Force. I think that's a little bit too much, too many Corruptors here. That's a lot of Corruptors. They will take out those Vikings without a problem, and those Broodlords are just standing back, doing a lot of damage to the ground units, as well as they should, because ground units are very effective against Broodlings. I'm just gonna shut up about things like that. And now more units streaming in from the SC. He's desperately trying to hold on to this game, but I don't think he has any way. Those defenses are all out of energy, they can lob only a few, and now the STC GG's. Great game, I really enjoyed this game to the fullest. It was a great game showing how the Zerg can expand multiple ways, multiple sides. This was actually a very tiring game. I actually lost my voice just a little bit. This hurt my voice. I was shouting for the most of the game. I hope you enjoyed this cast made by Solfex. Till next time, guys, keep it steady and carry on.